is up, you beautiful ladies and gentlemen from wherever you're watching this. I just want to say thank you. Welcome to Above Average. My name is Trevor. If you're new to the channel, leave a like, subscribe. It helps out the channel quite a bit. But let me turn the phone on silent. Shut up. Okay. Yeah, we got a lot to talk about. If you haven't seen, obviously you have seen the thumbnail, but we're talking Oilers this video. We talk all things sports, but this video I want to talk about Oilers. Why, you ask? Because the Oilers are 5-0, and currently the best team in the whole NHL. Are they really though? No, they just have the best record. There's a difference. So I just want to put that out there. Yeah, so I'm like a huge Oilers fan, a lot of you maybe know that. But if you're new viewers, maybe you don't know that. Yeah, I'm an Oilers fan, okay? So when the Oilers are winning, I like to talk about it because it hasn't really happened much at all, actually, growing up. They never were in the playoffs. How sad is that? I was an Oilers fan growing up and never once in my whole freaking middle school, elementary, high school, I never got to watch an Oilers game when they were in the playoffs. How sad is that? And I've been watching since like grade two, so that's sad. But regardless, the Oilers are winning nowadays, and there's a few players I'd like to talk about. So if you're an Oilers fan, which I am, I mean, you gotta love what you're seeing. You have to be pumped. I mean, for instance, I'm gonna be talking about a few players. Starting off with Zach Hyman. Need I say more? But he's got, what has he got? Four goals? Five goals? He's got five goals. He's got, in his last two games, he's scored four of those, which is awesome. You know, Zach Hyman, he's, so far, you know, done what, we've all wanted him to do. And I know, like, there was a lot of haters and a lot of people saying, you know, he's never going to live up to that contract. Well, to those people, Zach Hyman says, look at me now. Because he is, he's destroying. Five goals, one assist, 6 points in the first five games. It's looking real good. And one thing I really, really like about Zach Hyman is the players that do really, really well with Connor McDavid are the players that just crash the net. And you know, that's what he does. He talks about it a lot. He says, I like to go just to the net. That's something I've always done as a kid. And look at him. That's what he's doing now, and it's working out just fine. And you look at Patrick Maroon, that's a player that also just crashed the net. And Connor was able to give him like 27 goals or 26 goals 1 year. So he's like Patrick Maroon, but he's faster. He's got a better shot. He's younger, you know, so it's honestly, it's everything what I've wanted and more. To this point, I'm probably gonna jinx it because that's what I do. And knock on wood, just saying this right now, I'm gonna jinx all of this. As soon as I release this video, things will start to come back, down to earth. And they next play Philadelphia, so they're probably gonna lose that one like 4-0. Mark my words, I jinxed it here and now. But Zach Hyman's been huge. You know who else has been huge? Nuge. Nuge has been huge. He's got 7 apples to start off the season. No goals yet, but as long as he's putting, you know, some points up, that's good. Last year was a contract year for Nuge, and I think you could tell because he didn't really play the best. And, he's got 7 apples right now. He's looking real good. Keep Nuge forever. He's going to be the first, and he's going to be one of the first Oiler in franchise history to start his career as an Oiler and to end as an Oiler, hopefully. So that is awesome. Nuge, keep it up. You're looking super, super good. Also, who's looking good? Jesse Puljujarvi. This guy's just what a great story to have, you know, all the drama that we had a few years ago with him, and then him coming back, and he's currently leading. He's third on team scoring. He's got 2 goals, 6 assists. He's riding shotgun with the best player in the world. So if we could lock Jesse up, that would be great. You know, I can't see him, you know, being too selfish. He seems like a pretty kind guy. He's a very kind guy. So here's hoping Jesse inks a contract no more than 6 a year, hopefully. But that might not be the case. But Jesse, can he score? Yes, he can. And he is doing that. Only 2 goals, that is. But six assists is nothing too wrong with that. And he's looking really good. He's fast out there. I know a lot of people are saying, you know, we shouldn't give him a contract until, we see what he can do without McDavid. You know, which I'm not disagreeing with. Like, yeah, obviously it definitely helps playing with McDavid that he's getting these points. But I mean, the end of the day, he's getting these points with McDavid, you know, so why, you know, put him down, you know, to the third line? You're not going to put him down on the third line, and you're definitely not going to put him down on the fourth line, because who's going to replace him? So I don't really agree with that, but I kind of know what you mean. He needs to prove himself. It'll be nice to see if he starts getting, you know, some goals that, you know, he scored against Calgary there, you know, because a lot of these assists, I could assist a goal for Connor, you know, just give him the puck and then let Connor to work his magic. But speaking of goals, Warren Fogle goal. Yeah, nah, not that good. Anyway, yeah, Warren Fogle, I mean, this is great. I'll put a lot of these clips out for these guys, but yeah, this is sick. Sorry, that's my alarm. That means pizza's ready, so I'm going to be right back.
Pizza time.
The pizza looks real good, if any of you were wondering. Anyway, yeah, Warren Fogle, I mean, obviously this trade was probably the one that hurt the most during the summer, just because Ethan Bear, you know, just solid stud guy. I always thought he was going to make the NHL, like, the day we drafted him. And, you know, he did make the NHL, so I'm happy I was right about that. But regardless, he was a great player. Sucks to see him go. But I ain't never seen Ethan Bear go inside out like that. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, Ethan Bear, he was a great player and all, but I don't know. This trade is starting to look real good for us, I think, hopefully. I don't know. It's too early to say. I mean, it's just one goal. But that third line and another line, if you're an Oilers fan, you know what the third line I'm talking about. Derek Ryan with Fogle and Zach Cassian. I mean, yeah, it's looked super good. I don't want to be talking about Cassian in just a second, but Fogle, he's looked really good. He's kind of like a workhorse. You know, we got him, Hyman, and Yamamoto. They kind of all work or play the same way. You know, they're always just giving it every single shift. So you like to see it. But yeah, Warren Fogle, I mean, keep it up. That was so sick. So if you're an Oilers fan, be happy about that, because that's great. Scoring depth, I mean, we haven't had much of that in ever, honestly. I've never watched, seen this much scoring for the Oilers. So it's good. Yeah, and Zach Cassian, what a stud. I mean, he has more points, I think. I know he has more goals than he did all of last year. I think he's maybe matched his point total. And he's already just 4 games played. He missed the first one, remember? Yeah, so Cassian, I said this. I was like the first one that said this. I swear that, you know, some players, you know, they don't do well when there's no fans in the buildings. And I said that, and then everyone started saying that. So just putting that out there, TSN. Anyway, yeah, so Zach Cassian, keep it up. He's looked so much better. He's positioned. That's what it is. He's not lost. I remember before, just last year, he just always seemed lost out there. But, you know, he's finding the open spaces, and he's reading off of Fogle and Derek Ryan really well. So that is great. It's great to see, because, I mean, compared to last year's third line with the Oilers, so it's definitely a lot of improvements with Jujor Kara, Josh Archibald. I don't even remember our third line. That's how bad it was. Maybe Chiasson was there. So, yeah, it's looked really good. All in all, what I'm getting to about this is scoring depth. It's something the Oilers haven't had in so long. Like, I didn't even mention McDavid, the season he's having, and the start Leon's having. It's great to see. You love to see it. And here's hoping it's going to keep, you know, continue. But I know it's not, because I just jinxed it. So you can thank me later, Oilers fans. But anyway, haven't talked about him, but I'm going to now. McDavid, he has 49 points in his last 19 regular season games. He's putting up Gretzky numbers, like, essentially every time. You're looking at these stats, and a lot of people have been just comparing it to Gretzky, because, you know, Gretzky was one of the only players to ever do it, and it's insane that Connor's doing this in today's NHL. He's looking like a freak of nature. They often use that in the NBA. But, Connor's just a stud out there. Like, he's continued to progress ever since he was a rookie, which is obvious. Like, every player is going to do that. But it's such an astounding rate, and it hasn't slowed down at all. Every year he's joined the league, his points per game average has just only gone up. So it's so incredible to see. And, you know, will, you know, he keep up this pace? I don't know. I've learned not to, you know, doubt him, because did I think he was going to get 100 points last year? No. Like, I thought a 90-point season. And even then, I was like, that's insane. But yeah, so Connor, he's just doing Connor things. He's just making everyone look like rookies out there. And it's so incredible to see. I was going to say one thing about Connor. Let me think. What was I going to say? I got it. This is another crazy Gretzky stat. You know, I've been watching every Oilers game, so they like to come out with these. And so Connor McDavid, he to start off the season, you know, he's got 5 multi-point games. The only other player to do that in Oilers history, I'm pretty sure it's just Oilers history, is Wayne Gretzky. And that's crazy. Wayne Gretzky started off, I forget what season it was, but he did 7 games. He started off with 7 multi-point games. Connor's just 2 away. And in those 7 games, Gretzky was able to get, I think it was 21 points or 20 points. So, unbelievable. You know, 2 games, can Connor reach 20 points? I mean, 6 points or 7 points out, you know, if he gets 4 points one game and 3 points. I mean, I don't know. I probably jinxed it. I'm saying that a lot, but you're going to hear that a lot because I freaking jinx the Oilers, man. I always have. That's why I never say they're going to make the playoffs at the beginning of the year because you never know. That's one thing I learned about hockey. You never know. So even though we should theoretically make the playoffs, you never know. Okay. So lastly, power play. The Oilers power play. I mean, what? I have people calling me the saying like, man, it's unfair. Like just, and you know, being an Oilers fan, you're just so used to it. You don't really think anything of it. You're just like, it's kind of is what it is. But after, you know, really watching their power play and watching, you know, who were they just playing? Vegas is a skilled team and all that, but you could tell it's definitely just far and beyond, like, better. Like, it's so good. And, bold prediction. This is a bold prediction. I wish I put this in the bold prediction video that me and Brady did about a month ago. But, I think the Oilers power play will be better this year. And my reasoning for that is, you know, when you were in the Canadian division, you only played 6 other teams. And those 6 teams, you played up to 9, you know, times, you know, in the whole year. So, you know, guys, they remember tendencies. And, you know, the Oilers haven't played Vegas or, you know, they haven't played any of these other teams in almost 2 years. So that is going to be a huge advantage. You know, it's not like it was a crazy advantage that, you know, the Oilers power play still was first overall last year, but it was first overall and they were doing that against teams regularly. So it's not going to be as regular this year. They're going to play, you know, Montreal, and then they're going to play Boston, and then they're going to F off, come back home, and they're not going to see them for like 4 more months. And then, you know, so a lot of teams, they can't really, you know, get as prepared or accustomed to the power play until, you know, they're shorthanded. So it's going to be insane. I think that the Oilers could push 40% this year. Or high 37-38% Like, it's just insane to see. And there's so many things you can do. You know, you cut Connor off, then you got Leon. You know, he's one of the best passers in the world. Nuge is a really, really good passer. Barry's got, you know, he's also a really good passer. We got a super, super, super good net front presence with Jesse and Zach Hyman, which last year was Chiasson. So huge improvement there. So yeah, I mean, I think this power play will be better than years prior, which is just scary to think. And I think that just because they're so, you know, they know what they're gonna do now. Like Leon and Connor, they're, you know, buddies. They just read each other so well. So they've only gotten better with time, and I think with time this will, you know, only, it could go down as one of the best power plays in the world ever, which is crazy to think. So yeah, just a few things I wanted to say to you Oilers fans. This is a time to be happy, and you should be happy because this doesn't happen that often. So with that being said, there are 2 concerns quickly. Tyson Barry, he hasn't looked too good offensively and defensively. Last year he was chipping in offensively, so it made up for his defensive game. This year he's only got, you know, 2 assists in 5 games. It's not crazy good, but, you know, it's not bad, but it's not crazy good. So Barry, you know, and he's looked terrible in his own end out there. So it's hasn't looked good at all. You know, CC Keith and Bouchard Nurse, they've looked okay. You know, Slater Cuckoo's come in and, you know, a few games he's looked all right. But yeah, Barry, he needs to, that's one concern, I'd say. And Yamamoto, he hasn't registered a point this year, I don't think. So that's kind of scary because, you know, I don't think... first off, I was never too big on Yamamoto. I knew when he got, like, called up the 1 year and got, like, 27 points in 28 games, or it was something like that, 28 points in 29 games, that was obvious. I didn't think he was a point-per-game player. I think that was just the luck of the draw, and, you know, he came in at a good time when Leon was, like, really, really feeling it. So, he's definitely not a zero-point, you know, player, so... I think with only time, you know, I said that earlier, but he'll chip in one, and, you know, maybe once he chips in the one, get the monkey off the back. Definitely helps having Leon and Ryan and, you know, Yamo as a line again, because, you know, when they were first formed, I mean, that was something special to watch. So, you know, obviously, if the Leon Draisaitl line, Nuge and Yamo line, you know, start clicking like they did, that would be awesome, because then McDavid's rolling his line, and regardless, I don't think, you know, you'll never really see McDavid have a night off. Draisaitl, he can, you know, there's some games he looks a lot better than others, but, I mean, McDavid, I've never been like, maybe once I've said, he wasn't doing too good today, but, yeah, so those are the concerns. Oilers fans, you got a lot to look forward to. This is sick, you know, being an Oilers fan my whole life, I haven't been this happy in a long time. So it's good to see, but yeah, it's a quick little video I wanted to do for you guys, but I think it ended up being a little bit longer than that. So yeah, what do you think? Are the Oilers legit this year, or are they not? Is this just the beginning of the season, beginner's luck kind of thing? Let me know, I'd love to hear it. If you're new to Above Average, feel free to like, subscribe, you know, that's it helps out the channel. It's the best way of showing your support. I don't know what video I'm going to do next, but I've got a couple ideas, so stay tuned for those. And yeah, without further ado, have a great night, guys, and let's go Oilers!